If you enjoyed this video, consider supporting SmugStick on Patreon. Chala, het chala, na 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 na. Uko, sparking! Man, Dragon Ball is one crazy series. The story of a young boy with a tail has now been around for over 30 years, and there is no signs of stopping. Dragon Ball had movies, shirts, mugs, bath bubbles even, but most importantly, to me, video games. Dragon Ball games are very hit or miss. I guess they never miss, huh? And with that, I've already dated the video. But anyways, one of the most exciting parts about getting a new Dragon Ball video game is turning it on and being greeted by a brand new song and animation exclusive to the game. Well, most of the time. I'm looking at you, Xenoverse 2.
Attention, all proud warriors. Have you ever considered joining Time Patrol?
I remember the first Dragon Ball video game I owned, Budokai 3 for the PlayStation 2. See, I lived in Ecuador back then, and Dragon Ball was huge. Every kid in school loved it, and every kid had this game. We would always talk about what the best character was, and who was stronger than who. The game actually came out way after the Spanish dub was done, but for some reason, the Ecuador TV station never went past the Frieza saga. So, we were left wondering who the hell half the cast of characters were. Who is this Power Ranger? Why is there a giant bug? And how is Vegeta a Super Saiyan? It was truly one hell of a time. The game was great, super fun and fast paced. The soundtrack was a plagiarized marvel too. The composer, Kenji Yamamoto, stole from all over, but that didn't matter to us. What mattered was the fact that the jams were so good. But nothing beat the intro theme to the video game. Ore wa tokono... In English, I won't stop until the end. Most American players only ever heard the version without lyrics, and that's a huge disservice to them, because Hironobu Kageyama is a goddamn master when it comes to his singing. The whole song is incredible, with an awesome guitar and trumpets that make you want to throw down against Kid Buu. Well, actually, maybe not, because that fight was hard. The animation was awesome too, starting slow with Goku's shadow over some clouds before showing us Goku flying and the rest of his friends joining in. Then everyone begins to fight their respective enemies. A fight I find kinda funny is that at one point Goku and Vegeta fuse into Gogeta and battle against Broly. So this intro predicted the new Dragon Ball Super movie like 13 years before it happened. It even ends with Goku turning Super Saiyan 4 ready to fight against Omega Shenron. And say what you will about GT, that scene is crazy. But that's one game everyone and their mother knows and has played. What about more obscure titles? Well, I don't own it, but let's talk about Final Bout for the PlayStation 1. Final Bout was an interesting case. It was the first Dragon Ball video game to come to the United States after Dragon Power for the Nintendo Entertainment System. But the series was barely even out in the US, and certainly nowhere near GT. The series the game was based on. In fact, Goku wasn't even voiced by Sean Schemmel in this game. Instead, he's voiced by Spike from Cowboy Bebop. It came out for the PlayStation 1, and it was actually really, really bad. It had no right having such a kick-ass intro. The song is fine, again sung by Hironobu Kageyama. I know a lot of people like it, but I'm personally not a huge fan of this song. Especially not a fan of the fact that you can hear sound effects. Like, it's cool, but I would much rather just be able to hear the song. Now, the actual animation, on the other hand, is super cool. I'm especially a fan of how Super Buu regenerates into the scene. We even get a small glimpse into Goku and Vegeta when they're older, way after the Buu saga. Finally, we switch into Dragon Ball GT territory. And, you know, the cast fights some random robots. Yeah, a lot of fighting in this intro, but overall, I enjoy it. It ends with Goku running and all the enemies' faces appearing. It's a pretty cool way to end it. We've now been through both Z and GT, and Super doesn't really have any good in-game intros as of yet. So what about the original series? Revenge of King Piccolo was a neat little action game for the Wii that came out in a weird time period when Bandai Namco published OG Dragon Ball games rather than just Z. You know, Advanced Adventure, Origins 1, Origins 2, and this game. This game was actually really fun, from what I hear. It's actually the only other Dragon Ball game since the PS2 era that I don't own, since I never had a Wii. But this intro has some pretty nice looking, if a little wonky, animation. It basically leads you through the story of Dragon Ball, from Bulma and Goku's first meeting, all the way through the fight between Goku and Piccolo. The theme song, Power Dreamer, fits the game and is in line with older Dragon Ball songs, but I'm personally not a fan of it. I think it's too slow for the action on screen, but it fits the game overall. There is a lot of intros that I love, but there is one game that I've spent so many hours on, much more than any other game, yet I never get tired of the intro. That is Budokai Tenkaichi 3. This intro was so fast and theme so great. The animation is a little ugly, admittedly, but it does have another instance of the Gogeta vs. Broly phenomenon I talked about earlier. Though the intro really isn't anything too crazy, as it's just a little fighting, this song is really what seals the deal for me. Super Survivor was an anthem for my childhood. Again, however, the lyrics were cut from the American release for some reason. I have similar feelings for the Raging Blast 2 intro. Though the animation is much, much better, and the direction is really cool, it's just a lot of fighting. The song Battle of Omega, however, is the best from the PS3 and Xbox 360 era. I also want to give a mention to Dragon Ball Z Legends for smartphones, which has an incredible animation of an intro. I don't have much to say about it besides the fact that it looks really cool, but I hate the song that plays alongside it. Besides Revenge of King Piccolo, the Dragon Ball game intros I've mentioned are fairly action-based. But what about the part about Dragon Ball that isn't 100% fighting? In my opinion, those are the best Dragon Ball intros, the ones that have a good balance between character interaction and action. This is exactly what Infinite World has. My personal favorite Dragon Ball fighting game has an incredible intro. Sadly, it ditched the 2D animation of the previous two Budokai games in favor for some pretty nice CG. This intro begins in a way I love, with all our heroes enjoying life and having fun. Goku is out finding the Dragon Balls when he stumbles upon the 4th star. He happily embraces it as he recalls his late grandfather. The title appears and we are shown our heroes individually. Vegeta is training, Piccolo is meditating, Goten and Trunks are sleeping, Gohan is training with Videl, and Krillin is eating as 18 cooks. They all realize that Goku needs them, and they join in and travel to the lookout, ready for another battle. It's actually about the halfway point when enemies attack, and the action part of the intro begins. There is a huge battle where everybody helps, even the humans, and Goku throws a massive Genki-Dama. This is probably my favorite Dragon Ball intro of all time. This song is one of the last sung by Hironobu Kageyama for the PS2 era. It's full of life and super energetic, just what I love in my Dragon Ball. I think one opening that may rival it would be Budokai 2, and I'm seeing a pattern here. The Budokai games have got the best intros. It is similar to the feeling I get when watching Infinite Worlds. It focuses heavily on the Buu Saga, as it was the first game in the US to include it, and it's a little more action-oriented than Infinite Worlds. But it still has some great character interactions and a few glimpses into Dragon Ball past. This is all amazing 2D animation, with some fantastic storyboarding. In particular, I love the parts of Goku flying with the birds, and the androids trying to decide where to go. But there is so much more. Bulma yelling at Yamcha, Goten and Trunks flying away from Krillin, and everyone giving their energy to Goku. It's all awesome. And to bat, the song named Light a Fire in Your Smoldering Heart is an absolute joy, with some great backup vocals and the golden voice of Kageyama. This is my favorite song, but I think I like the actual intro of Infinite World a tiny bit better. We've seen some great Dragon Ball intros in this video, but I want to cover a really, really bad one before we go. Dragon Ball Z Legends, no, not to be confused with the one for the iPhone, was a PlayStation 1 game that was really popular in Japan and Europe. Sadly, it never came out in the US, but it did become one of the most imported and emulated games in its time. I own a copy, though I've never played it since I don't have a Japanese PlayStation 1. Anyhow, this intro is actual garbage. We start with the Dragon Ball scattering through Earth, looking a bit more polygonal than usual. We then see a desolate area full of random lightning and... oh, just renders of characters flying at you? That's super lame. At least the art is cool, but the worst part is when the Dragon Balls summon some CGI flame dragons that go into a statue of Purunga, making it come to life and... Oh my god, what is that? That's Purunga? Ew. Late 90s CGI really did you wrong, old friend. It reminds me of the Red Shenron in the American opening of Dragon Ball GT. I don't think I need to say anything else as to why this intro sucks, though at least the song's kind of nice. And those were my favorites, and some not so great, Dragon Ball intros for video games. Tell me down in the comments below, what are your favorites, and what are some of the ones you don't like? Maybe I'll make another list about the worst ones. Thanks for watching, guys. This has been SmugStick. Be sure to rate, comment, subscribe, all the good stuff, and until we meet again, bye-bye.
Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to SmugStick, unless you want to be destroyed.
Lord Beerus, that's hardly fair. But also, don't forget to click the bell icon to get notified when he uploads new videos.